Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Welcome to online class. Today we are going to see the topic Life Mathematics. In this exercise 4.2, first question. Here mobile phone is sold for ₹8,400 at a gain of 20%. So we want to find the cost price of the mobile phone. So the selling price is 8,400. Then gain percentage is 20%. So we need to find out here cost percentage. Solution. So if you want to find out cost percentage, means we have formulas. So first you will write whatever given in the question. Selling price is equal to ₹8,400. Then gain percentage is 20%. Then we need to find out cost price. So SP is equal to 100 plus gain percentage divided by 100 into CP. So SP is our 8,400. 8,400 is equal to 100 plus gain percentages 20%. So that means 20 gain percentages 20. Divided by 100 into CP. So 100 plus 20 is 120. Then 120 divided by 100 into CP. So 8,400 it's equal to 120 divided by 100 into CP. So this 100 is in division. If you are moving from this side, it should be in multiply. Then 120 is multiply. If you are coming this side, division. So CP is equal to 8,400 into 100 divided by 120. So 0, 0 we can cancel. Then 2 table. 6 are, 5 are. Then cancel with 2 table. 3 are, 4 2s are 8, 2 2s are 4, 0. 3 table we can cancel. 1s are, 3 1s are, 3 balance is 1. 4 3s are 12, 0 0. Then 1400 into 5 we want to multiply. That is our cost price. So once if you are multiplying, CP is equal to 1400 into 5. So 0, 0, 4, 5 are 20, 0, balance is 2, 5, 1 are 5 plus 2 is 7. So CP is ₹7,000. So answer cost price is ₹7,000. Next question, an article is sold for ₹555 at loss of 7/1/2%, then cost price of the article. So here we want to find out cost price CP, but loss percentage is given. So SP sold, it's equal to ₹555, then last percentage is 7/1/2. It is in mixed fraction, change into improper, 15/2. Then if you want to find out last cost price, means SP is equal to 100 minus last percentage by 100 into CP. So SP is 555. It's equal to 100 minus last percentage is 15/2 divided by 100 into CP. 555. It's equal to, so cross multiply 2 into 100. 200. 200 minus 15/2 whole divided by 100. into CP. So 200 minus 15 is, it's a 185. 555 is equal to 185 by 2 divided by 100 into CP. So we want to find out CP alone. So bring whatever it is there in that side. So CP is equal to 555. Denominator is 100. If you are moving that side, multiply. Then divided by that 185, it will come in denominator. Then 2 is in division, it will go that side, multiply. So 5 table we can cancel. 3 5s are 15. Then 3 7 5s are 35. Then 1 1 111 into 5 555. Then 37 1s are 3, sir. So 3 into CP is 3 into 100 into 2. 3 into 100, 300 into 2. It's a 600. So our cost price is 600. So the cost price of the article is rupees 600. A mixer grinder market at rupees 4500 is sold for rupees 4140 after discount. Then we want to find the rate of discount. So the how much percentage it's a discount we want to find out. So our market price is rupees 4500. Marked price rupees 4500. Then sold discount prices, it's a 4140. Rupees 4140. Then first you find out how much rupees is discount. So discount, it's equal to marked price minus discount price. So both you can subtract. 4500 divided by 4140 minus 4140. So if you are subtracting, you will get discount amount. So 360 is the discount amount. Then if you want to find out rate of discount, that percentage if you want to calculate means discount divided by that marked price into 100. So rate of discount, it's equal to discount divided by marked price into 100. So the discount is 360 divided by marked price is 4500 into 100. So two zeros we can cancel. 3 table. 3 ones are 3, balance is 115. 5 threes are 15. Then 3 table. 1s are, 2s are, then 0, 120. Then again, 5 table we can cancel. 3s are, 5 2s are 10. Then 2 is 20, 5 4s are 20. Then 3 table we can cancel. 1s are, 8s are. So rate of discount is 8%. Therefore, rate of discount, it's equal to 8%. Next question. The total bill amount of a shirt cost is rupees 5,575 and a t-shirt cost is rupees 325 with GST of 5%. So we need to find out what is the total bill amount. So first calculate. What is the bill amount for shirt? Then what is the bill amount for t-shirt? Then you can add both the cost. You will get the total amount of bill. So cost price of shirt is shirt. It's equal to rupees 575. Then GST is included for both 5%. Then bill amount is, so bill amount, if you want to calculate, we have the formula cost price into 100 plus GST percentage divided by 100. So cost price is 575 into 100 plus GST is 5%, 5 by 100. So 575 into 105 by 100. So 575 into 105 multiply, you will get 60,375 by 100. So denominator we have two zeros. So 603.75. So the bill amount of shirt is 603.75. Next you will calculate what is the bill amount of t-shirt. So cost price of t-shirt, it's equal to rupees 325. Then same again, GST is 5%. Then bill amount is, CP into 100 plus GST percentage divided by 100. So our cost price is 325 multiply 100 plus 5 by 100. So 325 into 105 by 100. Same multiply, 325 into 105 is 34,125 by 100. Same, we got denominator is two zeros. So, once if we divide with 100, we will get 341.25. So, the bill amount of t-shirt is with included GST 341.25. So, we want to calculate what is the total amount for shirt and t-shirt. So, therefore, total amount is, so cost of shirt plus cost of t-shirt you can add, rupees 603.75 plus rupees 341.25. So if you are adding, the total amount is rupees 945. Therefore total amount is, both shirt and t-shirt is rupees 945. Next question, if the profit earned on the selling an article for rupees 810 is the same as loss on selling it for rupees 530, then find the cost price of the article. So, if you want to calculate profit, means the formula is SP minus CP, then the loss is SCP minus SP. So, the profit is first, and then the article is selling on profit. If the profit earned on the selling rupees 810, okay, the profit is 810, same as is the losses, it's a 530. So right, profit, it's equal to SP minus CP, loss is equal to CP minus SP. So same, so article is profit earned rupees 810, then losses 530. So substitute here, profit is equal to, so selling price is 810 minus CP, then loss CP minus, so in loss selling it for 530, so then SP is 530. So both it is equal, it is given. So profit of case 1, then loss of, then again it's a loss of, is that SP is also same. So the profit of case 1 is 1 is equal to loss of case 2. It's given in the question. Loss of case 2. It's given. Then compare both the equation. You can compare that profit and loss. So it is equal. It is given. So 810 minus CP is equal to CP minus 530. So this 530, if you are bringing this side, this is negative. If you are bringing this side, positive. So 810 plus 530 is equal to CP. This CP, if you are moving that side, plus CP. So two times we got CP. So 810 plus 530 is 1340. So 2CP is equal to 1340. So 2 is in multiply. If you are bringing that side, division. So CP is equal to 1340 divided by 2. So cancel, divide with 2 table. So CP is equal to 670. So our cost prices, therefore, cost price is 670 rupees, 670. If the selling price of, next question, if the selling price of 10 ruler is the same as the cost price of 15 rulers, then find the gain percentage. So here we want to find gain percentage. So if you want to find the gain percentage, means first we need to calculate what is the gain. Okay, so here it is given. Selling price of 10 ruler is same as the cost price of 15 rulers. So we don't know what is the cost price of 1 ruler. So first let's consider what is the cost price of 1 ruler. So let's consider cost price of 1 ruler be X. Let cost price of 1 ruler be X. Then it's given selling price of 10 rulers, then same as cost price of 15 ruler. So selling price of 10 ruler is, it's equal to 15 into that cost price. So selling price of 10 ruler is same as the cost price of 15 rulers. So cost price of 1 ruler is X, means what is the cost price of 15 rulers? 15 into X. So it's a 15X. So this is the selling price of 10 rulers. Then we need to find out what is the selling price of 1 ruler. So SP of 1 ruler means it's a more than 1. So we have to divide. So 15 by 10 X. So 15 by 10 X is, it's a 1.5 X. So this is the SP of 1 rule. Then we want to calculate gain. So gain is equal to SP of 1 ruler minus cost price of 1 ruler. So selling price of 1 ruler is 1.5x minus cost price of 1 ruler is, we are considered as x. So minus x. So 1.5 minus x is, it's a 0.5x. If there is no number in the x, means you will consider as 1. So 1x. So 1.5x minus 1x is, it's a 0.5x. Then we want to calculate gain percentage. So the gain percentage is gain by CP into 100. So the gain is 0.5x divided by x into 100. So both numerator and denominator we can cancel x. So 0.5 into 100. 0.5 into 100, once if you are multiplying, so one decimal will goes. So 50. So 50.0, that 0 is known values, so it's a 50%. So the gain percentage is 50%. Next question. By selling a speaker for rupees 768, a man lost 20% in order to gain 20%. How much should he sell the speaker? So we want to find out SP. So cost price, selling price, we want to find out. So selling price of speaker is SP of speaker is given rupees 768, then last percentage is 20. Then if we want to find out S, then CP means cost price means we have the formula SP is equal to CP into 100 minus last percentage divided by 100. So selling price of speaker is SP of speaker is 768, then CP we want to find, then 100 minus last percentage is 20 divided by 100. So 20 minus 100 minus 20 is, it's a 80. So 768 into 768 equal to CP into 80 by 100. So we want to calculate CP. So CP is equal to 768 into 100 divided by 80. So 00 we can cancel, 8 table. If you are cancelling 768, you will get 96. So 96 into 10 is 960. So cost price is rupees 960. And gain percentage 20, it's given. If gain percentage is 20 means, what is our selling price we want to find out. So if you want to find, if it is given gain percentage means, if you want to find selling SP means, we have the formula. So SP is equal to CP 100 plus gain percentage divided by 100. So CP is 960, then 100 plus gain is 20% divided by 100. So 00 we can cancel. So 96 into 12 is, multiply 96 into 12, that is our selling price. So 1152. So if gain is given 20% means our SP is rupees 1152.